show you two chair test. You can see a pulse oximeter being fitted to a finger, and the pulse rate is 69 per minute, saturation is 98%. I will ask madam to just stand up from the chair, go to the other chair. Yes, you can see two chairs, and madam is sitting over one. The distance between the two chairs from front to front is 5 feet. And now we'll ask madam, please get up, move to the other chair, sit there, okay, come back to the previous chair. This is one movement. Kindly continue this for 5 such movements. She is moving at her own pace comfortably, and she is allowed to stop or even cease to work if there is a problem. This is two chair test. Basically, we'll be noting the post-exercise saturation and pulse rate immediately after the exercise and thereafter at every 10 seconds for 2 minutes. And basically, we are going to see the post-exercise recovery response. Now it's the 5th movement and she's going to stop. Well, please relax. Okay, her pulse rate after exercise is 92 and saturation is 98%. Let's see how does it change. Well, by now 10 seconds has already elapsed. Her pulse rate has come down to 77 and saturation is 98%. So there is hardly any dip. And we'll continue tracking pulse rate and saturation every 10 seconds for 2 minutes. This is 20 seconds. The saturation has come down to 97%, the pulse rate is 75 minute. So there is 1% dip in saturation. This dip is desaturation we call, and the maximum desaturation in the course of observation is called desat max. This 1% desaturation is perfectly normal and it can be ignored. Now again the pulse rate is 76 and saturation has come up to 98%. This is what exactly happens in normal people. But if somebody has got a disease underlying, like advanced COPD, interstitial lung disease where the lungs are shrunken, and heart failure or some other significant pulmonary or cardiac problem, this desaturation is more obvious. Again at 40 seconds, 98% saturation, there's no desaturation. So she is perfectly normal. So far the trend shows that she will not have any more dip in saturation, and the pulse rate has well settled to 71, 72 per minute by 50 seconds. This is two chair test. Let me come to the COVID patients. If a patient has got a lung involvement which is not apparent, and if you exercise the patient and look for the pulse rate and saturation post exercise the way we have just done, you will find desaturation. And if this desaturation is more than 3 or 4%, this is quite significant. I will ask people to arrange oxygen, whether required or non-required, that is a different issue. If it is more than 5, 6, 7, 8%, then it is more dangerous. These patients might require oxygen inhalations, and they should keep a vigil that their saturation doesn't go below 90% preferably. Sometimes the patients are having normal saturation at rest, but once they walk, the saturation dips. They do not know the saturation might dip to a dangerous level. People get maximum distress after going to bathroom or after taking bath. So if they track their desaturation on two chair test, they may be aware and they may use oxygen while doing these trivial activities or day-to-day activities. If this desat max increases over time, we have already crossed 1 minute 20 seconds and her saturation is 98%, pulse rate is normal. So she has got perfectly normal two chair test. But what I am talking about the patients, if a COVID patient shows progressive desaturation, that is an ominous sign, the patient should contact a doctor or a hospital emergency. Similarly, if a patient of COVID is showing improvement in desaturation, that dip of 10% is now coming down to 8% or 6%, he or she is improving. Thus, one can assess the course of the disease also. This is how, with the use of this simple test, one can understand whether the disease is progressing or the disease is recovering. And you may try this in your home or anywhere. This may come helpful for our patients. Thank you very much.